and it's also affordable. For those of you who are new, please don't forget to subscribe, switch your notification. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I have the last review of one of the three fragrances sent to me by Avon South Africa and Beauty Bulletin. This week I will be using the scent Avon Far Away Infinity. And yeah, let's smell it. Okay, and this is the bottle. All right, let's see what the description says on the bottle before we smell it. Okay, so this has touch of jasmine and vanilla, so I think we should be expecting something floral, something sweet. Okay, so let's smell it. Oh my word, shut the front door. This is so me. My gosh. Yeah, this is the one. Okay, I will be wearing this fragrance for the next week and I will come back with some feedback. Hey guys, it has been a week of me wearing the Avon Far Away Infinity. And yeah, I omitted to tell you guys with my first impressions that it is an eau de parfum and I was expecting it to last longer, you know? And it did. Like, oh my gosh, I completely loved this. I was super obsessed. I was spraying it every day, obviously. But even when I went out, I disregarded my usual fragrances of choice because this was just so rich and it literally lasted the whole day. Like, you know, after you shower, 2-3 jabs on your wrists and then 2-3 jabs here and you're good to go. You know, I was getting compliments from like everybody, regardless of the age group, everybody just loved it. What perfume are you wearing? Oh no, I'm wearing the Avon Far Away Infinity. It was just, oh, it made me feel good, you know? It really, this is my type of fragrance. And like I said in the Avon Aspire review, I am obsessed with floral scents. I love floral scents. So yeah, this brought about that confidence, you know, in usually going for what you're used to and stuff like that. And yeah, my nail is broken, but the show must go on. And I honestly would give it a 10 out of 10 because it is something that I would wear. And even after these reviews, I didn't think I'm gonna stop wearing it. There are zero cons that I can think of. My skin didn't react to it. Like, it was just perfect. It was super perfect. I adored this fragrance, still do. So this is going up there with a few of my favorite fragrances: my Carolina Herrera Good Girl, the Collector's Edition, Dior Addicts, Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue, and Gucci Bloom. It's also, I mean, what? Oh, Versace Eros Pour Femme. You know, those are my, and Roberto Cavalli, and I think also Vince Camuto. You know, those are my everyday fragrances and I really think this should go up there with those. Because, and it's also affordable. And the nice thing is it's very affordable, so it's a good buy. I'm so happy. Thank you Beauty Bulletin and Avon South Africa for giving me this amazing, amazing opportunity. And I look forward to working with you guys again. For those of you who are new, please don't forget to subscribe, set your notification bulb on, like the video, and if you have some constructive criticism about my setting, my hair, my makeup, my outfits, or what's on the rack, please do leave your comments down in the comment section below. See you guys soon with another review.